All right, and on that note, I'd like to invite the captain of the ship, Mr. Annurag Batra, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief, Exchange for Media Group and Business World, to deliver the welcome address.
I may read out from your notes. Don't want to do that. I'll have to take your fee away. Please give Ratnika a big round of cheer. She's a very brave person. I met her at an event which she was hosting for us on 10th January. And, you know, I'm the one industry that I should be a brand ambassador of is out of home, because I spend most of my time out of home. But the other industry, if I could be a brand ambassador, is entrepreneurship and events. These are two things I know a little bit. She was hosting a BW Disrupt event, and, you know, I have some pet peeves, and one of my colleagues did something, and, you know, she saw me in a very aggressive mode, and then she out of the blue texted me, and she came to meet me in the office, and, you know, she's been very brave. So brave people should be celebrated. I am brave too. I got married 18 years ago, so I think we should celebrate brave people. But that's another day. Today we are here to celebrate the auto home industry. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Mr. Stuart Taylor, who's the global CEO of Kinetic, who's come all the way, and we've allowed him without a badge. That's because out of respect, sir. So please give Mr. Stuart Taylor a big round of applause. He's the global CEO of Kinetic. He's been an entrepreneur. He served on the board of Guardian. He owned his own radio station, and he's done a lot of things before he started leading Kinetic. My old friend Suresh, young friend, but goes back a long time. Suresh, the fact that you're at Kinetic gives us hope, because, you know, Group M is the position, and Kinetic is at a position where you can grow the industry, and if the industry grows, you grow. I have lots of friends in the room. I did work in the out-of-home industry for a little while, and my ex-boss yesterday called me and after that sent me a text saying you'll disappoint me, because he sent an article and it wasn't printed in the magazine. Sunandan called me, wrote now works for a, you know, diverse firm which engages on gender diversity and stuff. This is an industry that I know a little bit because I worked in it. It has changed for the positive in the last 18 years that I've moved away from the industry actively. I used to be the head of the office of Portland in Delhi. I had the great pleasure of having team members like Gaur Gupta. That's where I lost most of my hair. He's the sponsor of the event today. He will not come. You know, some people feel great, oh, I've sponsored the event, but I won't show up. You know, it's like a statement of, like, you know, like I'm God's gift to humanity, but that's okay, which Gaur is. He's a very close friend of mine. He worked with me. But I want to tell you that I did work in this domain, and I was taking Suresh's viewpoint before I came up. The industry has moved forward in a way that it has improved. And if we had to take the initiatives that have happened in the last few months, one is the, you know, every industry has an association which in some way brings some standard practices. It creates a safety net. It creates training. The outdoor industry, out-of-home industry, has the Indian Outdoor Association. I think in the last few months, the membership has gone from 80 to 350. So that's a very positive step. It has involved agencies, media owners, intermediaries, printers. Most importantly, it has set up some standard operating procedures. Payments is a big area. Every association, whether it's an INS or IBF or an outdoor association, can help in streamlining payments, because I think that's the biggest area where, you know, in how POs come. So things have improved there. Let me also tell you that the media industry is growing. Our Pitch Madison Advertising Outlook, which is in its 18th year, forecasts that next year the outdoor industry will grow bigger than the normal average of the growth of the industry. And the growth will be more than it was last year. If you look at the out-of-home industry, on an average, it grew by 6-7%. There are players that grew by 10%. If you look at the other survey, which Group M brings out, which Pitch Madison doesn't bring out, it says our out-of-home will grow at 13%. So we are at an inflection point. And the beauty about Outlook is, out-of-home industry is, that the out-of-home industry is getting integrated with every possible medium. It is getting integrated with television. It is getting integrated with your mobile phone. It is getting integrated with cinema in some way. It's getting integrated with retail. Every kind of medium is coming together to, you know, so out of home is really an industry that will grow along with every other domain and subdomain. I also want to talk about the fact that since the time we started this forum more than 10 years back, this is the 11th year, transparency and objectivity are two things that have been talked about. Ethics, I think we've improved, you know, we've improved hugely because the environment that exists is very competitive. Players that are ethical, long-term, and are partnership-oriented are growing. I can also point out the fact that there are unique out-of-home opportunities. Some of those opportunities are represented in this room. For example, Armor, for example, Bar Talk, for example, Vioma. They're not traditional out-of-home opportunities. And there are many more that I may or may not be aware of. Digital screens. You cannot talk of any domain, whether it's, you know, a business domain, which is editorial, without talking of digital and digital screens. Suresh was telling me that this commissioner of South Mumbai told him, the municipal commissioner, that they're giving up a, floating a tender for 100 digital screens in Mumbai, and then they, if it goes well as a pilot project, they'll replicate it across their municipality. Now, if it happens in Bombay, it possibly will happen every year. Again, because I come from the media domain, apart from Exchange for Media, I'm part of Business World. So I can tell you that media as a category relies heavily on out-of-home. If you look at out-of-home advertisers, media will be among the top five categories. You, for example, if you look at some of the marquee out-of-home spaces, Google has taken it up. Facebook has taken it. Netflix has taken it. For some reason, I'm going to Hyderabad very often these days. My new investors are from Hyderabad. So I have to go there very often. And we've been doing events. And when I land in Hyderabad, the Hyderabad airport, which possibly some part is with Lakshya, at least that part is with Lakshya, has this Radha TMT, Rana Dugubati. How many of you noticed that? The Hyderabad Rana. So, you know, it's done in such a fashion that it looks like the airport is owned by Radha TMT. You know, it's everywhere. I know the promoter of Radha TMT is a very close friend of mine. I had dinner at his home on last Monday in Hyderabad, and he told me how much he paid for it. I mean, he paid a lot of money, but he's getting an ROI. So out-of-home advertising can, in a lot of ways, you know, create that halo. And he's doing that when the steel industry is not necessarily doing well. So he's spending more money in building a brand. I can keep talking to you about out-of-home. I'm not an expert like Suresh or Mr. Taylor, so I won't. But I just want to tell you that the industry is changing for better. If I had to put red flags, I'd like to put three red flags. One is I brought the issue of latest issue of Business World, which is on women entrepreneurship. It's a survey which says that it's difficult to be an entrepreneur in India, especially if you don't have hair. Sriranga, it's easy, you have hair. But for other people who don't have hair, it's difficult. But for women, it's tough. And we did a large survey. And we, so in the out-of-home, I know your wife is a out-of-home entrepreneur in Calcutta, you just told me. But mostly, the number of women, I'm glad I can see some women colleagues here, but in the out-of-home industry, both at the leadership and the middle level, there are less women. I'd like to see those going up. I'd say that women bullshit less. I'd say that again, I keep saying that. Second is the fact that agency and owners have to look at a long-term view. Our industry sometimes tends to be very transactional, you know, as if you're selling, but the best value comes from collaborative partnerships. And last but not the least, again, this is an issue that is being discussed. 18 years back, I used to go for meetings. My boss would send me to, Surandan would send me to meetings, is measurement. The out-of-home industry still does not have a robust measurement. With the integration of out-of-home industry with every other media, I think now is the time for measurement. And with people like Suresh at the helm of a leading agency, I see Mr. Sen was also here somewhere. Mr. Bhandula. You know, he's like the godfather of this industry. You are, sir. Let's be very honest about it. So I just want to say that when we come back next year, and my vision for the out-of-home domain is a two-day conference. You know, this is a conference we don't make that much money as we make in other conferences, but we don't do everything to make money. We do things to make sure our industry creates new leaders, creates new benchmarks. We're able to celebrate the best advertising, and we are able to bring out an agenda change and a conversation change so that the leaders of the industry note and it seeps down. As Ratnika mentioned, tonight we have the neons. I can tell you that, you know, I just came for a, you know, I was invited by the ministry to be on the board of these National Entrepreneurship Awards, and I looked at their process, and they called me to look at the process. I can tell you their process was very good, and I said that to the secretary, that really your process is exceptional. But I can tell you that ours are the most honest awards, and I can tell you we do awards in every domain, and you know, we do it in the news broadcast awards domain, and I lose friends every year we do it. I can only tell you that people don't talk to me for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 5 years. But really, we do it honestly. Nobody in our domain can influence it. Whatever we do, we can say that we do it with a very... And we do it through a jury. And again, our jury, as you will see in the jury AV, is such an accomplished and knowledgeable jury and such powerful leaders that it'd be difficult to influence them unless until they... really get influenced by another jury member's view. So really, tonight when we celebrate the winners in the out-of-home domain, and there are two people awards, I know those are the only two awards I know who those award winners are. I can tell you, if I was on the jury, and I know a little bit about this domain and about this industry, I would give it to those two people. So I can tell you that if you won, I congratulate you. If you were in the shortlist, I still congratulate you. About 62 brands participated in the awards, 40 odd agencies participated in the awards. We got 350 plus entries. We shortlisted 120, and today about 30 odd winners will be celebrated tonight. So that's the process. I hope you'll agree with our award winners. Awards are a lot about three things. One, it is about perception. I can tell you again, that's an area I know a little bit. Second, it is about elimination. Awards is a process of elimination. So you keep eliminating, eliminating. And third, it is the quality of how you present the awards. You know, I keep saying to this, a lot of my friends reach out, but we did so good work. You know, our Prime Minister is a great guy, he's leading the country. He's there, apart from the fact that he's brilliant, his perception is bigger than reality. You know, if he comes back as the Prime Minister, he'll come back because there is perception is bigger than reality. If he doesn't come back, he'll not come back because perception is bigger than reality. So really, I can tell you this is the most honest awards. I don't have to tell you, you know. I just want to, and I want to tell you that next year, I called Sonia, who really put this together. Of course, lots of people, Priyanka, everyone has supported her. But I can tell you that one of our best is running this award. In a year where I met two jury members on the flight, I came back from Bombay last night. I told you I am the best guy on out of home. I'll be again back in Bombay tomorrow night for our Impact of 50 Women Awards. And on Friday, I'll be in Calcutta for our real estate conference. I can tell you that I met two industry leaders. I won't take their names. Both are very senior, and they had gone for judging of the GoFest. And I ended up asking them, so how was the judging? How was the quality of entries? What was the quantum of entries? I can tell you the last year, because of demonetization, GST, has been a tough year for advertisers, for the industry. I think we've done out-of-home advertising media industry has done particularly well considering those things. So while the quality and quantity of entries may have not been like the years before, I know that this is an aberration. This is a new normal. In some way, we'll have to accept it. And hopefully, all the good work that the government is doing in terms of infrastructure, in terms of creating jobs, in terms of making sure India is marketed, you'll see the results of that in terms of the economy doing even better over the next few years. I wish you luck, and I hope that I continue to be your friend, even if you win an award or you don't win an award. And I'd like to say that out-of-home industry is at a juncture where it's poised to become mainstream. And I remember I wrote this column 12 years back. Some of you are new in the audience. I wrote in this column, I used to write for Pitch. Jyotsna, there was a time I used to write a column for Pitch. I wrote, I was in Cannes. I used to go to Cannes. There was a time I don't, Naval doesn't send me anymore. But it was 3 a.m. in the night, and I was getting a call from Mukesh Gupta of Graphisat. And he's also my neighbor, so I took the call. And he said, he realized that, you know, I'm sleepy. I told him I'm in Cannes. I was sleeping. And he said, no, no, I'll talk to you. I said, no, no, tell me. He said, I've just read your article that you wrote in Pitch. And, you know, you've been very insulting on the out-of-home industry. Because I wrote that in our industry, there is the, I simplified it. I said TV, television, radio, and outdoor. I mean, I had to make it simple. I said television is the Brahmins, so on and so forth, and out-of-home is whatever. Can figure out, okay? He said, that's not good. I said, you have to read my full column why I'm saying that. But I can tell you that if I wrote the same article today, you know, I wouldn't say the same. We are poised. We've made a significant investments in technology. Some of the players represented today are, you know, investing significantly in technology to make sure the offerings are measurable. And that kind of measurability and honesty will grow the industry. I want to share my last story, and I've shared this at every out-of-home conference. So, Bhandula Sahab, agar bore ho rahe hai, toh koi baat nahi. You know, I remember I joined J. Walter Thompson. I used to be in media planning. Mr. Sanjoy Chakravarti used to be the boss, right? I was like a young executive. I'd worked for 4 years. And Mr. Sanjoy Chakravarti was notorious for reading too many newspapers. He was always relaxed. I've never seen a boss so relaxed. Like, he would read newspapers 2 hours, like, sit in his cabin. And I joined out of HTN, and then I was given out of home. And Sunandan hired me. And then I met Gaur Gupta, and I asked Gaur, tell me about the industry. So Gaur, of course, told me the right things, but I didn't believe. I thought Gaur was lying to me. I said, these are not possible. So one of the things he told me is that there is this guy called Mr. Singh, who had said, I've forgotten even his first name, whatever. Good, I've forgotten. Some Mr. Singh, who used to own lots of shelters and space in Delhi, which he doesn't own, so most of you know who I'm talking of. And he said he changes shelters 2-3 times a day. And he builds all the clients. I said, how is that possible? How can you do that? So I didn't believe him till we used to have NGC, Maruti, and one more as a 3 large client. And I remember I was crossing Asian Games Village Complex. There is a bus shelter, and as per us, there should have been a NGC hoarding, and there was some other client. So I called Gaur and I called that guy. He said, no, it is not possible. It is NGC. I said, I'm standing there. I didn't take a photograph. I don't think mobile was that ubiquitous then. I came back, and on the way back in the night, again, I went to that, and he had changed it. It was NGC. So, you know, I believe that I think we've come a long way from. Yes, so we've come a long way. I'm saying this because this was how out of home was perceived. Again, I said perception is bigger than reality. By bringing measurement, by strengthening the association, by bringing better quality of people, by upgrading our beliefs, I think we can grow the out of home industry. And as I said, this year is an inflection point, and the out of home industry will grow more than 11%, because that's what we've said. The other report says 13%. But we'll be happy if it grows 15%. So I wish you luck. I'm sure you'll be meaningful partners to the brands that you work with, to the organizations that you work with, and you will be socially responsible in the kind of advertising you display. And we are talking in a time where the Me Too issue is a big issue, where in advertising we started to look at, you know, because I wrote my article yesterday for Impact of 50 Women, what kind of role models we are creating. I don't know how many women winners are there. We don't have a women winner in those 2 people categories. Next year, I'd like to see women leaders in this domain winning. That's what I'd like to end on. Thank you. God bless you.